you want to be the father of our child? She's not your kid.
The hell she isn't.
Look, Liza and I will raise this child. We will be her parents, her only parents.
You have no right to keep me away from my daughter. I am her biological father, and I intend to be her real father.
I don't like ultimatums.
I'm not giving you an ultimatum.
This was a clinical procedure.
Now it's something different.
You're a doctor, for crying out loud. You should have some objection.
It's a very complex situation.
When this all started, we didn't know how we were going to feel. But I certainly didn't expect I was going to feel this way.
Well, I love this child.
We all love this child. And that's great. The more people who love her, the better.
Well, good. We agreed then. We all love this child. The issue is, simply, how best to express that love.
Oh, no. The issue is her paternity.
No, please, see, I'm not this father. Child is not some sort of prize.
He wants to love her. Is that it? Because I'm not stopping him.
Jake, we want to raise her. We want her to have a peaceful life.
That's all I want, Jake. A normal family life for Colby.
I really doubt you want a
normal
family
life. Obviously, we're not going to settle this, okay? Because we love her and we want what's best for her. All of us. But what's best for her is not three people deciding who gets to love her more.
I'm sorry, I yelled. I was just a bit surprised that you were asking to be her dad.
I am her dad.
Can we please stop this?
I'm only trying to respect Liza's wishes, Jake. When I proposed to her, I told her that I wanted the three of us to be a family, a real family. And I meant that.
And I accepted his proposal because I love him.
I only want to be a real father to Colby. I feel I already am. I was with Liza when she had her amnio. I've been with her when she wasn't feeling well. I've cooked for her when I wanted to keep her off her feet. I've loved her. Day and night. And I will do everything in my power to protect her and that baby.
I appreciate that, but Adam, it doesn't change anything. It really doesn't.
Well, I appreciate your position. But quite frankly, I don't understand it. You're a Martin. Of all the clans on this earth, I would think we could expect to count on a Martin's word first.
This is good. What's your point?
My point is that you promised Liza that you were going to stay out of her baby's life. You promised that. You had no designs on being a father. Right, and I understand you're getting closer to that due date and you're having second thoughts. But you gave your word, Jake, and you are a Martin, and Martins keep their word. Now, I'd like for us both to be men of honor here and keep our promises. You can love Colby all you want, but from a distance, not as her father. And I will raise Colby, and I will love her the same way I love her mother. What do you say?
Oh, this is precious. Here's a guy who's never kept his word to anybody in his life. He's told me I have to keep my word.
We're not talking about a stock buy here, Jake. Oh, we're talking about the life of an innocent little human being.
You don't need to tell me that. Right? I was raised to keep my word. I was also raised to be informed about the situation.
Oh, here comes the wiggle.
Apparently, when Liza and I discussed this whole baby situation, I wasn't filled in on all the facts.
Well, what facts, Jake? You said you would stay out of her baby's life. Now, what fact would change?
You back in her life.
Oh, I see. This isn't about the baby at all, is it? It's about me, isn't it?
You know, I want you to stay away from my daughter. Do you understand me? Do you understand me? I have seen the kind of father you are to your kids, and I do not want you to ruin my daughter's life.
Your daughter? She's my daughter too, Jake. And do you honestly believe I would ever do anything to hurt her?
I know you are going to be a great mother to her. I know that. That's not my problem. What if something happens to you, Liza?
Nothing is going to happen.
What happens? What happens to the baby?
She will be taken care of.
By you?
Yes, by me. I will be her father.
No, you will not be her father. I will be her father.
All my children will be back in a moment here on ABC.
All right. Let's just settle down here for a moment. We all are well aware that I've never won any nice guy awards for being a father, if anything else. I can see why you might have your doubts about
me. I have my doubts. That is just... I can think of a better way of putting it.
Under these circumstances, I would be protective, too.
Oh, protective, dominant, what else? Brutalizing?
Possibly, yes. But isn't it also possible that I've learned from my mistakes?
He said it. He makes mistakes.
Can you cut him some slack, please?
Well, can we just keep this down a little bit? The stress is not good for Liza or the baby.
Don't patronize me. I'm well aware of the effects of stress. I'm more concerned about the causes of them here.
Jake, I've made some very bad mistakes in my relationships with people.
Sure you have. You pretty much screw people up, down, left, right. Inside and out.
I'm sure it seems that way to you, and I'm sure in your eyes I'm a pretty awful person, but I've changed. And I've changed because of the love of this woman. Liza's love has changed me.
He has changed.
I see that he's convinced you, Liza. He's very convincing. You're right.
Do you think that I would stay with him 1 minute if he hadn't changed? He's accepted responsibility for wrecking our first marriage. He has laid down his life as a promise that he's not going to make those same mistakes anymore. Don't I deserve a second chance? How am I supposed to get you to believe that he's really changed?
I have every confidence in you. I think you're going to be a fantastic mother. She's very lucky, you know.
Yes, she is. She's going to be loved and nurtured by her mother and her father. Me and Adam. Please, don't do this. Let her life be simple and uncomplicated.
I wish I could make her life simple and uncomplicated. But it isn't. And neither was this decision. Maybe you two need to take some time to get used to it. And I've got to go to L.A. for a convention. And when I get back, we'll go over the fine points of everything.
So, that's it?
Liza, I'm committed to this baby. In my heart and my mind, she is my daughter. That will never change.
Did he?
No. I really didn't see it coming. You were great.
Oh, I was stunned.
You didn't get angry? I mean, you didn't scream.
I don't scream much anymore.
No, but you really tried to talk to him.
Didn't do much good, did it?
What are we gonna do?
I said we're just gonna hold on. Hold on. We'll think of something.
And the I'm so sorry.
No, no need. No.
I thought that Jake and I were on the same page, that we were in agreement. I never would have done this if I knew he'd renege.
Well, then we wouldn't have Colby, would we? Everything is going to work out fine.
I just thought you'd be spitting tacks. I mean, I don't know why you could be so calm.
Well, I'd be happy to have a fit if you'd like.
Well, maybe that's a good idea, just so I know things don't change.
Nothing has changed, has it?
Adam, Jake wants his name on the baby's birth certificate. He wants equal access to Colby.
Well, he can want whatever he likes. That doesn't mean he's going to get it.
Yeah, but he's going to try to get it. I know him.
Liza, do you realize that I love you more than any man has ever loved any woman anywhere?
Yes, but...
And you also realize that you were engaged to a very powerful man named Adam Chandler, who can move mountains, etc., etc.
You're good, but you're not God. You cannot change the fact that Jake is the biological father to this baby.
Oh, I can. However... do everything in my power to make you happy. Don't worry, I can deal with Jake's threats.
Am I gonna like this? You want to elope?
Well, we have a problem here. I'm offering a solution. You will be Mrs. Adam Chandler by the time the baby comes. And on Colby's birth certificate, where it specifies father, will be my name for all the world to see.
Adam, we can't.
What if you're afraid of flying and the baby? Well, we'll get a car. We'll find some mom and pop organization, you know, sort of a justice of the peace type thing, and somebody can warble. Oh, promise me, off key. Come on, let's do it. We both want to. It's what we both want. What do you say? Unless you're having second thoughts about marrying
me. No, that's not.
Because I'm going to make it work this time. I'm going to make you happier than you ever dreamed of being. And we're going to have exactly what we wanted. A family. You, me, and Colby. Come on, say yes. Say yes. Come on. I'll make it happen, I swear. Go.
Adam. Your plan is not going to work.
Why? There's nothing to stop us.
There's Jake.
To hell with Jake.
Adam, wake up. Jake is in the picture. He wants me to sign sworn documents saying that he's the biological father before the baby's born. If I don't, he's going to go to court. And there's going to be a court-ordered paternity test to prove he's the biological father.
Can't file a paternity suit.
Yes, he can. He's had his rights read to him by Trevor Dillon.
No, he waived his paternal rights when he signed that document, when he went into this deal. There must be papers he signed at the clinic.
It was a verbal agreement.
Oh. Liza, that was a little short-sighted of you.
Jake and I were friends, Adam. I trusted him. At the time, there was no reason to get a lawyer involved.
All right, there's nothing can be done about that now. Did anyone hear him say that he was going to stay out of your child's life?
Tad did, but Tad is not going to testify against his brother. There's no reason that Jake can't change his mind. He never signed a release, so he's not relinquishing paternity.
Relinquishing paternity. Jake is not the child's father.
All My Children will be back in a moment here on ABC.
What do you mean? Jake is not the child's father. Without Jake, there wouldn't be a Colby. Denying that little convenient fact sounds like the man that I divorced.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. I just think of her as your child.
You and me both.
Jake! How dare him! How dare Jake put you in this kind of an impossible position?
I don't blame him for changing his mind. After all, he is Colby's natural father.
He donated his sperm. His rights end there. I don't donate a pint of blood.
and then claim part ownership of the recipient.
That's not a fair comparison.
Well, I'll tell you what's unfair. It's Jake creating this kind of tension when you're on the cusp of giving birth. And all because he doesn't think I'm a fit father. Liza, this baby is part of you and me. She's not a clone or a lab experiment or some battle to be won or some object to be claimed. She's a little child with a heart that's bonded to the very core of your being. She's God's gift to the two of us, to you and to me, and no one has any right to interfere with that. I already love this child more than words, more than reason. In my heart, Colby's my daughter.
You're smiling.
Give me one good reason.
Okay, because Colby wants you to be happy. Come on. The future's not as dark as it seems.
Says you and what crystal ball?
We've come through hell and high water to get where we are today. We haven't come this far to let Jake Martin undermine us now. The gods aren't that ironic. Neither fate nor fools can touch us now. You've got my word on that.
Oh, Barry, I wasn't aware that I didn't hear the bell.
Winifred let me in. How are you, Adam?
Yeah.
Who's your friend?
Just a toy that I picked up for Colby. I want to make sure that it's safe for infants. What do you think?
It looks safe to me.
Did you bring the papers?
Oh, yeah, I've got your new will right here. What's the urgency? We usually review this the day after your birthday. Is everything all right, Adam?
What? Oh, yes. Yeah, I'm fine. I'm strong as a horse. It's not the reason I called you. Good, you made the corrections that I asked.
Well, I was somewhat surprised by your generosity.
Well, it will all come clear as I fill you in. Barry, everything that's said in this room today stays right here. As my lawyer, our conversations are confidential and privileged.
Of course.
That means Liza, too.
Oh, I see.
No, I don't think you do see. Liza... I hate lying to Liza more than anything, especially now. But I got to keep this from her. The rest of our lives may depend on it.
I thought everything was going great for the two of you. The changes to your will certainly reflect that.
Well, everything was fine. I was on cloud nine until a couple of days ago when I stupidly told Jake Martin that I was going to remarry Liza and that I wanted to be Colby's father.
Jake Martin again, huh?
Well, no, not like it was. He's only in the picture because of the insemination issue. He's suddenly gotten a bad case of parental possessiveness. He's even gone so far as to hire Trevor Dillon.
I see. So I'm correct when I say that Jake Martin is not the father of Liza's baby.
How the hell did you know that?
I've been your lawyer for many years, Adam. I did the deals for the fertility clinic, remember? When you had me secretly buy it, then turn around and sell it just as abruptly, I had my suspicions. What I couldn't figure out is how you pulled it off.
You don't want to know. Suffice it to say that I had help.
And this bait and switch produced...
Liza is carrying my child. Colby Marion Chandler is a Chandler. But we've got to keep Jake from claiming her. Whatever it takes.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Here, have a banana, darling. Have two. They're full of potassium and magnesium and calcium. Or at least I think they're full of calcium.
Hmm.
Have you been reading nutrition books again?
Of course I am. I'm becoming an authority. And speaking of nutrition, darling, you don't look very well. The circles under your eyes are competing with the circles under my eyes.
First of all, you don't have circles under your eyes. Second of all, gee, thanks, Mom, for the compliment.
Oh, I'm sorry, Liza. I know you must be stressed out. Last night I just tossed and turned. It's a wonder that Stuart got any sleep at all. All I could keep thinking about was Jake demanding to be the father of little Colby Marion, just when everything was going along so perfectly.
Mother, please don't. I have managed to get through the morning without crying about it. There's nothing you can do about it.
Oh, yes, there is. Darling, I have got the perfect solution.
Hopeless, Mother. Jake's mind is made up.
Darling, it's all how you look at these things. So Jake has a little yen to be a daddy, so just let him.
Great. Problem solved, except for one little detail. Adam and I don't want him interfering in our lives.
Liza, there are other children in the world. He doesn't have to be Colby's father, you know. Now, what if Jake were to meet a nice, beautiful woman with a child? Or with child, for that matter, hmm?
Well, that's a great idea. I can't believe I don't have my magic lamp and the genie.
Well, I've got something much better than that. Listen to this. Okay. Family man wannabe is seeking beautiful single mother or mother-to-be. I am a single doctor, handsome, tall, with brown eyes, and I'm eager to be a daddy.
Mother, you didn't. You didn't run a personal ad for Jake,
yes,
did you? Yes,
isn't it great? Especially the single man wannabe. I mean, I think it really grabs your attention. I mean, I just want Jake to find a wonderful woman who's been knocked up. You know, and I've always pictured him with someone very artsy, you know, like a piano player or a violinist in a chamber orchestra.
Mother, you didn't run this, did you? Please tell me you didn't send this.
I faxed it to the bulletin last night. It was in this morning's edition. Why, is there some typo error? Oh, well, they'll catch it, I'm sure. Anyway, you know, the bulletin has a very small circulation, darling, so if we don't get any calls from that ad, I'll place another one in the intruder next week.
What are Jake's demands?
He wants to be recognized as the child's legal father. He wants his name on the birth certificate. And he wants to play a significant role in the child's life.
As her father.
Yeah. Ironic, isn't it?
And what's Dylan saying?
Well, according to Jake, if she doesn't give him what he wants, he's going to file a paternity suit. That means blood tests.
Yeah, which will prove that he's not the father.
That's right. I know that. We have to stop him.
But think about it, Adam. The blood test can't prove you're the father unless you take one. You're not planning to take one, are you?
Not until the time is right, no.
So why not just sit back and call his bluff? He'll lose in the end.
Because Liza is much too smart to think that this was some sort of innocent switch at the fertility clinic. She's finally going to uncover the fact that I happened to own the clinic when she got pregnant. You got to help me out with this, Barry. I can't let her walk out on me again. Find a loophole somewhere, something Trevor Dillon overlooked.
Trevor Dillon gave his client good advice. There's not much room for maneuvering on this one.
Well, if his advice is so infallible, maybe I should hire Trevor Dillon at half the cost. Come on, Barry, help me out. Get me out of this.
If Colby becomes a Martin, she'll be fair game to the whole Martin clan. Believe me, they'd like nothing better than to undermine my relationship with my daughter, particularly Ted Martin.
If it comes down to that, the only Martin that will have rights to your child is Jake. And since you are global, maybe you and Liza should consider a brief stint abroad, or at least the West Coast. Makes it more difficult for weekend visits, you know, jet lag and all.
You mean uproot my entire life for Jake Martin? No! Never! Wait a minute, Barry, you may just have started earning your money. Why would a young doctor like Jake Martin want to stay in Pine Valley when there are so many opportunities elsewhere?
Do you think you can get him to leave?
He's in Los Angeles right now, delivering a paper at a convention there. That presentation is going to be astoundingly successful. He's about to be offered a job that he can't refuse.
You sent them here to my office to see me.
We have to screen the women first. We can't just have Jake marrying any old mother. Besides, you know him better than anyone. You know if he's a leg man.
Mother, no.
We're pulling the ad. It goes.
No, Liza, it's perfect. I mean, you're helping your friend out. You're helping him find the woman of his dreams.
What are we talking here? Have we suddenly become Heidi Fleiss and Huggy Bear? No, Mother Jake could just sue me for custody based on the fact that I'm insane.
Liza, but...
No, but, Mother, it's lunacy.
Well, I was only trying to help. I mean, Stuart told me to stay out of it, but I thought that... Oh, darling, I didn't want to make things any worse. Do you really think that Jake will sue for custody if he finds out about the ad?
Look, Mother, probably not, okay? I was... Stuart was right, though. You should really stay out of it. Please. And stop worrying about me. I'm fine.
Darling, I'm always going to worry about you because you're my daughter. And I love you. I mean, you're just about to get all the happiness you deserve in your life. And that's what I want for you more than anything in the world, Liza. And I just don't want this Jake business to get in the way.
Neither do I. Okay, and I know that you are just doing what you think is best. And I love you for it. I really do. But please, if you love me, go to the bulletin and make sure you cancel the ad.
Right now?
Okay, yeah, Mother.
No, Stuart's just about to
meet me. Mother, I have to meet Adam, and you have to go now.
Oh, okay. All right, darling. I'll run down there lickety-split. I'd do anything for you. You know that. I love you.
I love
Bye.
You, too.
Contact the hospital. Find out which conference Jake is attending and the time of his presentation. Then call Dr. Marshall... Forrester at the Concordia Medical School. Tell him you need a referral. Somebody to offer a plum position to a young doctor who specializes in emergency medicine. Yes, that's his specialty. And west, way west, L.A., San Francisco, Honolulu, maybe.
Hey, did I hear Honolulu?
Hello, Liza. You're looking well.
Oh, yes, I'm looking big. Did I interrupt?
Barry and I were just wrapping up some loose ends. And I threw Honolulu at him as a possibility for a honeymoon.
Oh, you and Barry, or me and you?
And on that note, I'll get back to you on that outstanding matter.
Yes, you do that. Here we go. Thank you.
This outstanding matter? Did this have anything to do with Jake Martin, perchance?
I cannot tell a lie, yes. I'm hoping that he can get us out of this nightmare.
Something legal, right?
No, there's no other way, Liza. I'm not going to take a chance of messing up our relationship at this point, not now.
Sound like my mother.
Oh!
You do. She ordered me to be happy, and trust me, she's willing to do just about anything to ensure it.
Well, really. Well, I'm getting to like your mother more and more.
Well, the two of you are very alike, you and your little schemes.
We both love you. That's what's important.
So, what were you and Barry doing with all those papers?
I was having my will redrawn. In case something was to happen to me, I want to make sure that you and Colby are well taken care of.
You are well taken care of. Are you all right?
Yeah, oh yes, I'm fine. I never felt better. Do you think I would leave you now that I finally have you in my clutches?
Well, you would tell me, though, if something
yes.
was wrong.
Of course, I would give you every boring detail. Just in case the sky should fall, I want to leave the bulk of my estate to you. There would be some to charity and to Stuart, of course, and the remainder... which is considerable, will be divided equally among my children. Sky, Haley, Adam Jr., and Colby.
Adam, you don't have to do that.
Oh, yes, I do. Colby is my child in every sense of the word. I couldn't love her more.
Well, do me a favor, all right? You stick around for a long, long time.
Yeah.
I think I'll have my will redrawn, too. Leave everything to Colby and you.
Well, that's a good idea since you got it all for me in the first place. talk about a return on my investment.
Oh, please. I got three words for you, mister. Fiber optics and Vigaro.com. I'm going to show you something. Wall Street Herald. Here it is. Okay. Aha. Read it and weep. Up 25 points since the beginning of the year. Your money was just merely startup money.
Well, my accountant will be pleased.
WRCW has delivered the best revenues ever since the beginning of the year. I have been living large on my own.
You've been living large, mm-hmm. but not on your own. No, not yet.
It's true.
Why don't you try to find us an investment for young Colby? Ms. Mogul?
What time is it?
Ow.
Oh, look what you made me do. Where is it? I'm going to be late. It's my first Lamaze class.
Well, let me go with you.
Oh, no, don't be silly. You haven't read the book.
Okay, of course I've read the book.
What book? What book?
Well, if there's a book, I'll read it, I swear.
On the way?
Well, do you have it with you?
It's not... It's... Like that. And you breathe slow and deeply. It's... In and out, and you scrunch up your mouth like so.
Let me see that. Oh, no way.
What do you mean, no way? It's just breathing.
Okay, it's me looking like an idiot breathing.
Well, nobody's taking your picture, Liza.
Oh, they better not.
You couldn't look like an idiot if you tried.
I'm not doing that. It's not natural looking.
It's not natural. Well, why are we here? This is natural childbirth, isn't it?
No, if it's so natural, why don't you do it?
Hey, just relax, okay? You're pushing up your blood pressure pushes up Colby's blood pressure.
You talk to me like I'm a horse. I'm not a horse. Yet if my BP is spiking, it's not me.
Okay, I just want you to calm down.
I'll be calm. Good. Stop showing me pictures.
Okay, all right. If that's the way you want it, whatever you think.
You know, I'm having this baby, and I'll have this baby any way I want to have this baby, okay?
Okay.
And you know what? I'm doing all the driving from now on.
I was trying to make life a little easier for you.
Easier? You park 5 blocks away from the entrance.
Well, I wanted you to have some exercises. The book says you're supposed to exercise.
Stop showing me these pictures.
Sorry, I wasn't thinking.
You know, fine. I will walk all the way to the loft. Alone.
You're not going to walk to the loft alone.
Okay, folks. What seems to be the problem?
Him.
I love the time and in between. The calm inside me. In the space where I can breathe. I believe there is a distance I have wandered. Touch upon the years of reaching out and reaching in, holding out, holding in. I believe this is heaven to no one else but me, and I'll defend it.
This is heaven to no one.
Look, I know all this can be very confusing, especially at the beginning.
It's natural childbirth. How confusing can it be at this point?
That's a good question.
Is there a good answer?
Lots of things we do naturally were learned, like walking. I mean, nothing could be more natural, but we had to learn to do it, right?
That's a good answer.
Look, why don't you come a few minutes early next week?
Oh, gee, we could be on time. There's a concept.
Hormones.
No.
Pregnancy can be very stressful for everyone.
You're telling me.
Especially for people who are used to being in control. Now, for the next few months, the baby calls the shots, okay?
But I know that I'm kind of tense. I've just never been through this Lamaze stuff before.
Yeah, that makes two of us. And I want to be the best labor coach that I can possibly be, but my reviews so far have not been good.
Well, would you like to carry this around for a little while?
Don't worry. I haven't lost a parent yet.
What can I do to help her?
Just take care of Liza the way you would want her to take care of you if you were in pain or trying something new and difficult.
Well, she's done that for me plenty of times.
Well, there you go.
I think I can do this.
I have absolute confidence. Is this your first?
It's our second.
Do you guys know when Erica's gonna be back?
Back from where? Isn't she in her room?
No, I assumed that she was having tests taken.
Erica's having tests? For what?
Unless there's a problem.
Hey, I'm gonna find the nurse, see what's going on.
I want you to take a look at these. Shots of Erica laid out so that the damage to her face is hidden.
Oh my goodness, as if she knows. Her coat, her shoes, they're not here.
Her coat? Why would you need her coat? I mean, is she strong enough to go out?
Myrtle tells me you're looking for Erika. I checked her charts. She's not scheduled for any tests.
Well, her coat is not here, Joe.
Ah, well, there's no need for alarm. So she probably is exercising. I asked the floor nurse to check the solarium.
Joe, is she strong enough to go out alone?
No, not alone, but she'd have the assistance of staff. Because it's also possible she went to see Dr. Weiss.
With the plastic surgeon, that wouldn't make any sense.
Why not? Poor darling's going to have major facial reconstruction.
The subject is off limits.
Yeah, but she's been asking a lot of questions.
Well, she's a very intelligent woman.
Yes, and everybody has made sure that they haven't said a thing about it.
Well, yeah, but it'd be just like her to, you know, take the bull by the horns and go see Doc Weiss on her own.
You know, my money's on Opal. I'll bet that's where she is. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Martin?
Yes?
I checked with Dr. Weiss. He hasn't seen Miss Kane, and she wasn't scheduled for an appointment.
Did someone check the solarium?
She's not there.
Well, thank you, nurse.
Joe, where could she be?
Joe, how could the staff not know where she is?
Oh, you know very well that if Erika Kane gets it in her mind to do something, then she does it.
Oh, dear. Well, David says sometimes that cardiac patients do have, you know, bizarre post-op symptoms.
What kind of bizarre?
What? Well, psychotic episodes.
Psychotic? What are you...
I will go and alert security.
Just come by and do this every morning.
I intend to.
We didn't get to do this with our child.
Liza, do you ever wonder what our child would have been like?
I think about that little life all the time. It comforts me to know that we'll be together someday. It's strange.
What's strange?
Well, when I think about our baby, I don't feel sad. It's like I have this peaceful feeling that comes over me, like a completion. As if a part of me has gone ahead to scout things out.
I wish I felt that way. When I think about the baby, all I think about is loss. I feel loss. I feel loss for the child, for the family that we would have been, for us. There's only one thing that makes me feel better. Seeing you. And feeling our baby.
Well, we must have done something right. Because we're being given a second chance to do it all over again.
Yeah. We're gonna be good parents.
We're gonna be great.
But only if you go...
Surgery.
Well, the staff is checking floor by floor.
Well, I'm sure Erika's going to be found before anything happens.
What could happen?
What's going on?
Erika's missing.
She's gone.
What beauty of scarred for life vanishes. WRCW cannot be shut out on this.
I know. Bottom line's the bottom line, but Erika's teetering right on the edge. If word gets out now of her disappearance, there could be a panic. Her stockholders will jump ship. And Erika will crash right along with Enchantment, psychologically and physically.
I just think that we need to let people know. If the public sees her, maybe they can stop her before something bad happens.
Give us a little more time to locate her. Lights and camera are not what she needs right now.
Well, somebody's going to get the story. And maybe somebody a lot less sympathetic.
I can see why RCW is in the black. You're good.
I'm the best.
1 hour, please.
Or what?
Or I will circulate photos of you going...
You're the best. And you got it 1 hour.
Thanks. I'm going by the Enchantment office.
Yes, sir.
Has anybody gotten any news to David?
No, he's still in surgery. I did, however, just speak to a nurse who says she definitely saw Erika getting into a cab in the employee's parking lot. Security is checking and calling the cab company.
Well, meanwhile, I'm going to get word to David.
I'll be in my office if anybody hears anything.
Oh.
cab company.
Dimitri, did you check Erica's houses? She could be in the dark somewhere in a bedroom.
I did a room-to-room check. There was no sign that she'd even been there.
Listen, I know where Erica is. She's at home.
Dimitri already checked London.
No, where she was brought up. She's at home. Mona's.
Didn't they sell that house?
No, she couldn't bear to sell it.
You know, she rented it out. There are people living there that would call.
They might not be in town.
That was the cab company. The driver who picked Erica up says he dropped her at 20 Adams Street.
That's Dr. Tyler's old house. I knew it. Erica's at Mona's.
Let's go.
Oh, thank you for saving this, Mother.